Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see some very special alkyl groups. On the top of the screen, we have a model SN2 reaction with its transition state in the middle. We need to focus on this transition state. I tried to draw the transition state to highlight how the carbon goes through a planar geometry when considering just the hydrogens around the central carbon. A planar carbon calls back to trigonal planar geometry that we saw in sp2 carbons. Many people actually consider the carbon in the transition state to be sp2 hybridized. The carbon then would have a vacant p orbital that is interacting with the incoming nucleophile anion and the leaving group anion. Great, why is this relevant or important? Well, it explains some of the reactivity trends that occur in the SN2 reaction. On the bottom of the screen are three alkyl bromides. The top one is called benzyl bromide, the middle is allyl bromide, and the bottommost one is called phenacyl bromide. All three of these alkyl bromides are surprisingly reactive in the SN2 reaction. What's so special about these alkyl halides? The common trait in all is the presence of a pi bond next to the carbon bearing the leaving group, the bromide. The general thinking is that the neighboring pi bond with its p orbitals has favorable interactions with the p orbital that we showed in the transition state for the SN2 reaction. So we can draw the transition state of a nucleophile reacting with allyl bromide, and I have three carbons on the screen, and see what this p orbital is doing. So this will be the carbon that's being attacked, and we'll act like we're in the transition state. Let's put hydrogens on here. These angles won't be perfect. Here is the double bond of our allyl group, and again we need hydrogens coming off approximately like that. We'll have a hydrogen poking out in the back, and we'll have an incoming nucleophile and a leaving group leaving and partial bonds forming. The interaction of the p orbital in our electrophilic carbon, it will get some type of overlap with these neighboring pi bonds. This interaction of the p orbitals stabilizes the transition state. And so here is maybe what an energy coordinate would look like for an SN2 reaction. If we pull down the energy of our transition state, and let's say it drops to here instead, then what's happened is we've lowered the activation energy, and therefore the reaction occurs at a faster rate. So when the electrophilic carbon bearing the leaving group is next to a pi bond, SN2 reactions become much more favorable. The faster rate is normally explained by orbital overlap considerations in the reaction transition state.